Hi everybody, my name is Newell Davis and I'm here with Wormaculture. And I wanted to go over, as one of my first videos here, the bins that I have. I have four on the floor here. These are all 10-gallon Rubbermaid totes. I have one here in the corner that is a green brute, I think 32-gallon trash can. And then I have one more up here, which is a 27-gallon Commander XXL. And there's actually two of them. I have them nested with holes in the bottom, and then I have a little spigot here on the end to drain out the liquid. And I thought I'd go over these bins with you so you could see what I'm dealing with and maybe help you deal with bins yourself. So I have found that these 10-gallon totes are actually the best bins. It was really surprising to me. I really thought that the other ones would be good, but these are the best for two reasons. One, open one up here. As you can tell, there is a ton of worms in here, actually. And this bin is in horrible condition, and they still seem to thrive. I can't really figure it out, but they seem to really multiply in here. You can tell as it gets more wet, there's a few big ones in here. This is way more damp than it should be, but it works. I have multiple of these because, as you can tell here, the lid is also really wet. You can see by the shine on it. But these bins just seem to work. Let me just show you some of the other ones here, too. You can tell this one has some food in it. Look at all the worms in there, though. I top feed. This bin, again, is way too wet, but you can see the liquid built up on there. You can see the huge worms in there, though. As I said, these bins, I tried one like this. I found it worked. I've built more, and all I do is I puncture holes in the sides. I don't put any holes in the lid. That way I can stack them up. This one smells a little bit bad, but it's probably because there's still food in it. Here we go. Here's the third one. Now this one is much newer. I still have the burlap in it from when I made it. Oh, the burlap's completely ripped through. There's worms in there, but I don't have as much food. This one is much drier, too, if you can't tell. I mean, you can tell there's no liquid buildup really in there. But so it's much drier than the other one, or two that we checked. Although there's still a lot of liquid here on the top, and it's even dripping out of there. So, put that one back on. And this is the first... This last one here is the first Rubbermaid bin that I made. And this one is really wet on the lid. Actually, it's dried off a little bit. I put in a lot of cardboard to try it dried out. Now, this is one of the reasons why I really like these bins. These are heavy. I know you can't tell, but this thing probably weighs 35 to 40 pounds, maybe even 45 net by now. And they seem to really do well with that type of weight compared to my bigger bins, which... I didn't think about when making my first one here. I'm going to turn around here real quick. This one right here, this was actually my first bin that I made, and I lost all the worms in it the first time. I didn't have the nested. I just had one of these, and I had holes in the bottom, which is actually this inside one now, and it just did not do well. Now I'm going to take the lid off here, but I don't have any light over here, so really, you can't really see. The lid, a little shiny, but not too bad, not really that wet. I grab the light here, and as you can see, this is also another bin that there's almost no food in. I haven't been feeding very much because I'm going to empty all these out soon. You can see, I don't know if you can see with the camera here, but there's little bugs on everything in here, the little mites and everything, which is normal, and I really haven't had any issue with them. They don't really leave the bin. You can see them actually on the back wall a little bit too, moving around. Some worms there too, of course, but the one thing that was really disappointing with this bin is... this drain spout. It has not drained a single drop since I put this together. And this bin, even though it has very little in it, is really heavy and very hard to move around and use. In fact, I can't even use it to drain. I can't lift up the back to drain it off, really. It's really hard to do, and I'm always afraid I'm going to drop it. So I have not found this to be a very useful bin. It's also really big. It's hard to dig through. It's just much bigger than it should be. So that's my review on that type of bin. Now my last bin here is a 35-gallon. I cut a little hole in the bottom here to make it a pass-through for, you know, the flow-through bins. I have one big issue, as you can tell, there's a lot of liquid built up in there, and it's actually overflowed a couple times. And I don't know the best way to get the liquid out of there. I put stuff there to absorb it, and then I kind of throw it back in another bin, but I haven't figured out a really good way to take care of that. So, you know, I'm not sure exactly what to do. Now I just have cardboard on top of this. Throw that off to the side. Now this one has a lot of food in it right now. There's some worms, as you can see right there, and on the sides. There's more worms as you get down into the bin. And if I were to turn this, I'd find a whole bunch. I tend to let them sit and work their way up to the food. I have had some bug issues in here before with gnats. They seem to... I usually load it up with newspaper and they go away. If I have another issue, I will take a video of that and I will show everybody how I deal with it. But I haven't really had an issue lately. So those are my bins. I have six of them if you lost count there. And so far I do. I have to say, these are the best bins that I have. I'm actually going to empty, I think, all these bins out today. And kind of, except for the one that's pretty new, but I'm going to try to restart them. I've got way too much stuff built up in here, and I'm going to basically just dump it in my yard and let the yard take care of it. So this is my first video. Hope you guys enjoy as I continue to go over what I'm doing with these bins and how I'm doing it. Thank you. Bye.